Hey y'all, welcome back to another vlog. Today is Sunday, September 24th. I am currently outside of Target, go figure. I'm not going to church today because we had our girls' day yesterday, and yesterday was self-care. I was not picking up my iPad, I wasn't looking on Blackboard, I was just, it was self-care. So I was like, if I'm gonna make Saturday my self-care day, then Sunday is gonna have to be grind time. So I'm getting ready to run in Target and grab me a Celsius and probably head to Starbucks to get some work done. I am watching church online though, of course. I'm gonna try to run in here really quick, and I need to grab a couple of extra things, and I shouldn't be in here too long. Prayerfully, the Lord snatched me up and I just ran my tail out, because I know how Target can get. But these are my nails. I feel like y'all can't really see them, but it's the first time I've ever gotten almond shape nails, and I really like them. They've grown on me. I'm normally a coffin, square, squoval kind of girl, but I don't know, I like these. So we'll see if I keep them. If not, oh well. But I'm probably gonna listen to church for a little bit, and then I'm gonna head into Target.
I probably got me a few, I do.
You can keep talking about me as long as you're keeping it cool.
Lord, forgive me. They do not know what they do.
No, thank you. I have a mobile order.
What's the name on that?
Janae.
We'll see you out the window.
Thank you. You already know where I'm at. Okay. I'm in this line at Dunkin'. Getting my free coffee. Y'all know Dunkin'. If you order through the mobile app, you get a free medium iced or hot coffee on Mondays. Ciao. These glasses giving auntie, but it's all right. I came and got my coffee. It's Monday, it's a teacher work day, and I don't have to work. I put that annual leave in so fast. So I ain't have to work today, honey. Should've gave myself a paper cut. I'm so glad. I ain't liking this. Anywho, I'm so glad I didn't have to work today. It's like 10:00. First of all, that clock wrong. My clock say 10:08, but it's a little fast. But I'm in the line at Dunkin'. I am gonna head to TJ Maxx after I leave Dunkin'. And then I need to go to the coffee shop to have quiet time and to catch up on some stuff for school. So today is gonna be preferably very productive. I've already made my grocery list of things that I need to buy for the week. Truthfully, I've been eating out for the past like 3 weeks, and combining that with not being in the gym, it's giving weight gain. And I'm not trying to basically undo all the progress that I've made this past summer. And I know it's not going to undo itself overnight, but I know that with not working out and eating whatever I want to, the gains that I've made can quickly go out the window. So yeah, I need to start back meal prepping, because for one, my birthday coming up, and two, I really this summer desired for healthy eating and working out to be a lifestyle, not just something that not something that I just did because, you know, it was popular, I was planning for a trip, or it was the summertime and I wanted to be snatched. Like, I want it to be something that I practice on a daily basis. So it's still a work in progress, but yeah, we starting back meal prepping today. So I also want to use this day to relax as well. So I may watch some movies, some TV shows, kind of binge watch some things, and also get caught up on some work here and there as well. I also need to wash my hair, and I'm trying to figure out at what point of the day is that going to fit into, because I already feel like with everything I just said, the day is already going by fast. And I feel like something going to have to get cut short because my hair is dirty. Dirty. I'm gonna have to figure something out. I normally am a caramel, iced coffee, iced latte kind of girl, caramel all the way. But I opted to get French vanilla today because I've been seeing videos on TikTok and people act like French vanilla is the best thing since sliced bread. So I was like, let me try something a little different. Like, I definitely do like French vanilla flavored things, but I'm just a caramel kind of girl because caramel is sweet and I like my iced coffees to be sweet. Not too sweet, but definitely a balance of not too much coffee. Well, that's kind of a lie. I like a little coffee in my creamer. Like, I like my coffee to be light skimmed. Okay, I wanna taste my sugar. Like, don't give me diabetes, but definitely let me know what's in there. But we gonna see what's going on. I went to the leasing office one day last week to use the computer lab in there to study, and I had an iced coffee that wasn't sweet enough. And they have a coffee bar in our leasing offices, and in our leasing office, and I was putting more creamer in my iced coffee, and the guy that works at the front was like, girl, how much creamer do you need, sis? Like, come on now. I was like, it ain't sweet enough. He was like, oh, you like your coffee sweet. I was like, no. That's like, girl, yes you do. Yes, you do. I called my mama this morning to tell her that that Duncan had free coffees on Mondays if she ordered through the app. My mama really is the one that put me on the Duncan, like, for like years ago. I remember when I was living back home in middle school, high school, probably elementary school, she would always go get her a medium extra extra. That's her order. It never changes. It never, or she might do a medium double double. Them orders right there, sis ain't straying away. And then I remember Duncan came out with like a cookie dough iced coffee, and then me and her would go get that like almost every day after school. And yeah, my mama put me on the Duncan. Shout out to you, sis. I really, personally, I like Duncan for their coffee. I like Starbucks for their refreshers. But if Dunkin' kept their lemonade as an option for their refreshers all year, I would definitely be a Dunkin' girly more often. But them green tea, period. So I'd rather have lemonade. Lemonade. Now, baby Shook, this person in front of me at Dunkin' been sitting here a minute. I don't know if they cooking her stuff, if the coffee won't right or what. But the line kind of a little long now. Oh, here we go. Look at Jesus. Look at God. All right. I had a mobile order. Uh-huh. Thank you. You too. My coffee not giving light skinned it. And it's not giving that I'm gonna like it. So I'm a little worried. Oh no, sugar pie. Sugar pie, sugar pie. Mm-mm. This ain't giving jack. I'm like, I don't know if I should. But see, here's the issue. I like almond milk creamer. And they don't got that. So I'm like, if I take it back, they're going to put creamer in there. And it's going to tear my stomach up. So I don't know what I should do. All right, we're going to try this again. There was a Dollar Tree next to TJ Maxx. And I said, Lord, I ain't about to go buy no whole bottle of creamer from the store right now. Because I need to go grocery shopping anyway and get creamer. But I'm like, I ain't got time for that. So I found this Splenda coffee creamer. Didn't know Splenda made coffee creamer. But we're going to try to see if we can do something with this coffee. And truth of the matter is, I'm not really going to be too upset about it. Because, I mean, I didn't have to pay for the coffee. But still, I had a taste for coffee. And I want my coffee to be right. Lord. I keep forgetting I got nails on. Because I can't open nothing. Oh, Jesus. Now that's battle. Wait a minute now. It's still not my level of sweetness or the way I would want my coffee to taste. But that's definitely a lot better. Now I just need some more ice. I truthfully could use one more pack of Splenda or something. I wonder if I got a pack in here. Nope, I don't. I didn't find anything I was looking for in TJ Maxx. So, this trip was kind of a fail, but it's all right. I did end up getting like this accessory bag. I've been looking for like a bag I can keep all of my memory cards, external hard drive, all that stuff in. So I did get like a bag for that, but that was only like $6. So that was pretty much it. I've been trying to find some workout sets for the longest time. And I'm not trying to spin an arm and a leg and a foot and a toe. And some of these websites that sell workout gear, they were trying to take your whole limb just to pay for some leggings. And I normally like getting my leggings from TJ Maxx because they're really good quality and the price isn't too bad. But they didn't really have any in my size today, so it's all right. But I'm about to head to the coffee shop and get started on editing the vlog before this. And then have quiet time and get some work done. I decided to stop and get tropical smoothie for lunch. After I left TJ Maxx, I started to kind of feel sluggish. And I was kind of sitting here like, Lord, what is going on? And I've actually been kind of feeling this lately. Like, since school has started, I've been drinking a lot of, like, Celsius and coffee. Just trying to keep myself awake. So, I think on top of that, and then me not eating the best and getting my greens in, I think my body is trying to like process all of this caffeine I'm taking, but like it's not being balanced out with pretty much anything. Like most of the time for breakfast, I either skip breakfast because I'm running late to work, or either I'll get a smoothie, but I'm not really eating, I guess, eating something of substance that has like bread or something that can really like hold me for real. So I had, you know, that coffee this morning, but the only thing I had with that was hash browns. And I don't even think I ate dinner last night. So it's like I keep feeding my body caffeine, but I'm not feeding my body like real food, like greens, spinach, fruit, vegetables. Like I'm just eating, trying to get by because like I've been so busy over the past couple of weeks. So I was like, because I know I'm about to go to Starbucks. And anytime I go to Starbucks to study, I'm probably just getting a refresher and getting like just something quick to eat. But it's not food. Like it's not chicken. It's not, you know, food, like food. So I came to Tropical Smoothie and got a smoothie, and I got them to add some spinach to it, and what else did I get? Oh, and I also got a grilled chicken flatbread. So I'm getting ready to head to, Lord, where am I going? I'm going to Starbucks and I'm gonna get started on some work. I have finally made it back home. And I just came from the grocery store getting my food and stuff for meal prep for the week. So I'm getting ready to put my groceries up, cook really quick, and get my butt in the bed. I'm really gonna try to be in the bed early tonight. Lord, what is this camera doing? I'm really gonna try to be in the bed by a decent time tonight so I can go to the gym tomorrow at 4:30. So hopefully that works, that things go as planned.
It's okay, Shay Duncan. Would you like to try a pumpkin spice signature latte?
No, thank you. I had a mobile order.
What's the name on that?
Janae.
We'll see you at the window.
Thank you. It is Wednesday morning and I am headed to work. If I look tired, it's because I am a little bit. I got up this morning at like 4:50 to finish my hair. I stayed up last night. Well, I didn't stay up late. I washed my hair last night and only did half of it because I was trying to be in the bed by a certain time. And I was like, okay, if I go to bed early, then I can get up in time enough to finish my hair. I ended up having a meeting last night after I got off work that lasted longer than I wanted it to last. So I wasn't able to do everything that I had planned to do. So some stuff had to get pushed back till today. And I don't know, I just wasn't willing to push back washing my hair because I was supposed to wash my hair like 3 days ago. And my hair, I could just tell it was getting dirty and my scalp was starting to just do what it wanted to do. And I was like, yeah, I need to wash my hair. So I got in the shower, washed my hair, detangled it, did all that. And I was still in the bed by 9 o'clock, which was good. My goal was 8:30, but 9 o'clock still wasn't bad. But I set my alarm early this morning so I could finish doing my hair, which I did. So my hair is washed, detangled, moisturized, all the things. I got out of the house early enough to be able to go by Dunkin'. So I would say we're doing pretty good. It's only 6:50 and I'm like 5 minutes from my job. So we're still making good timing. But after I get off work today, I have to go straight to the computer lab. Like it's not even an if, and, or but because I got some things going on that I can't really talk about yet. So I've been trying to get some stuff together. So my schedule kind of been off this week, but all is well. I'm getting to work on time, so we praise God. And the fall weather is in the air. I ain't gonna lie, I went and got a chai tea latte this morning from Dunkin' that I normally get. And it ain't tasting how it normally tastes. So I'm gonna try to get to school and see if I can make something shake because this ain't giving jack. Ain't giving nothing. Like it's not disgusting, but I don't taste, like I paid an extra, I think $1 for an extra pumpkin swirl because sometimes I feel like they don't put enough and it's still not giving pumpkin nothing. So I don't know if it's just the girl who made it or what, but it's not sweet at all. So yeah, we'll see. But I'm praying that today is a great day. It's Wednesday. It's hump day. The week is almost over, and we praise God. I'm in the Starbucks line because Duncan had me messed up yesterday, so we got to do a redo. I wanted an iced pumpkin chai tea latte or pumpkin spice. And I don't know what the heck Duncan had going on yesterday, but it was not giving nothing but coffee. So we're going to try it again. It's 6:45. I'm 5 minutes away from my job. So hopefully Starbucks can get me in and get me out. Because I actually left the house at a decent time. And I didn't even go to bed early last night. So that's a record for me. So hopefully they hurry it up. Get me in and get me out so I can get my tail to school. Hold on now. I know they ain't got me 7. Okay. Yeah, but it's Thursday. I'm so glad tomorrow's Friday because I'm tired. We had a 4-day week this week and I'm still tired. Baby sugar, you've been at this window a mighty long time. Mighty long time. It's low-key given I wasn't prepared this morning when we opened up because I'm like, baby, I've been at the window for a little minute ordering my stuff and the people in the front up here. Still hasn't moved. They still haven't moved yet. And now it's 6:47. And I need them to come on ASAP. ASAP. I finally got put on the schedule. Not finally, but I volunteered to be put on the schedule for the praise team coming up. So I'm excited about that, truthfully. I mean, of course it's gonna push me to trust God because woo child, now we're getting into the swing of it. But I am excited. I can say that. I am excited to see how the Lord will move through me in this process. And my camera is getting ready to die. Isn't that great? Y'all, we are officially in hoodie season. I'm so happy. I don't know what to do right now. It is currently 8:52. Hold on. Hold that thought. Hold it.
Hi, welcome to Starbucks. My name is David. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing fantastic. What can I get started for you?
Can I do the strawberry acai lemonade refresher in a venti?
Venti strawberry acai lemonade. Oh, did you say the lemonade or just a normal refresher?
With the lemonade, yes.
Gotcha. And sorry, my memory's failing me. You said venti or is it Trenta?
Venti.
Awesome. Anything else I can get for you today?
Can I add liquid cane sugar to that?
Liquid cane, of course. And does that complete your order today?
Yes.
Awesome. It's going to be $6.89. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
No problem.
He was so sweet. But my principal sent me home from work today because I think he could tell that I was not feeling my best. So I've been in the bed really all day. I got home around like 9:30. And so now it's almost 9 o'clock at night. And I'm tired of sitting in the house. And I also need to get some work done. And I also need to spend time with God. When I was at my old job, every Friday I would go and take a drive and just kind of worship and talk to God about how my week was. And I had gotten away from that. So I think I'm going to do that tonight. I normally come by here, grab a drink from Starbucks, and just drive on the highway until I don't feel like driving no more. And so, yeah, I think that's needed tonight. I got my little pimple patches on because my skin throwing up gang signs, but that's all right. The show must go on. Y'all. Oh, Jesus. Me and the Lord having a moment, okay? We having a moment. So, oh Jesus, I guess to calm down. There's this song, Oh Father, that our praise team did a few weeks ago called The Well. I'm gonna leave the name on the screen by the original artist. But baby, let me tell y'all, something. Listen, there's this guy named Brandon on the praise team that led this song. And baby, ooh, if bro ain't come to play, okay? He said, I'm snatching everybody's edges if the Holy Spirit allowed me to. But I recorded it on my phone in a voice memo from the 11 o'clock service. And I was sitting here, you know, going on my little drive, having my little moment. Y'all, ooh, ooh. So the word, Jesus, the words to the song start off like, Lord help me. I can't even think now. Hold on. Jesus, help me, Lord.
Father.
I can't even think of the words. Hold on. I might have to play it. I wonder if I'll get copywritten since it's not the original song. Hold on. Y'all might not even be able to hear this, but that's all right. We're going to get it. Baby, you're going to use your signal light in Jesus' name. That's what you're going to do. That's all right, because we're going to get a word out of this right here today, because this thing is blessing me. Hold on. You're not a limited source, but you are a well that you don't discriminate for. Only give us what we need. You go over and beyond. Shake a foot. And if I give you my cup, that it will run over. So I'll gladly take a drink. Do y'all hear this? Wait a minute, I got to go back. I got to go back because, baby, hold on.
Drink, 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 drink
have no words. I just, y'all, I was done when they said you are not a limited source. I don't know why that hit me different today, but like, I feel like we really be thinking like, when life be lifing, and I'm gonna speak for me, I ain't gonna say y'all. When life be lifing, I really be thinking like, God has limits. Like he actually runs out of the stuff that I need. And I saw this post on Instagram the other day that said like, when we don't trust God, it's like we say that God creates children that he can't take care of.
What? Oh, Fata.
What? And the thing is, we know like, we know that's not true. God don't create illegitimate children. He's not like man. God is not out here making babies and it, like that he can't take care of. Now granted, he may not always come how we want him to or come when we want him to, but we be taken care of though. I don't even know if y'all can hear that song, but the lyrics literally say, you are not a limited source, but you are a well that won't run dry. You don't discriminate or only give us what we need. You go over and beyond. Oh, my word in heaven. Oh my, like, Jesus. I don't know. Y'all, I have played this song for the past couple of weeks, and it ain't never hit like this. He doesn't just give us what we need. He goes over and beyond. They're gonna continue on. And then it says, if I give you my cup, I know that it will run over. I know. Ooh. So I'll gladly take a drink. Jesus, you satisfy me. You're the well that won't dry up, so I'll keep drinking. It's the Jesus was at the well part for me. Because I know he was at my well. Okay. Jesus was at my well, okay? Because if he won't there, baby, I'll still be sitting there. Looking like boo-boo the food. Okay. That would have been me. If I need peace, I'll take a drink. If I need strength, I'll take a drink. Overflowing fountain. I'm over here singing overflowing mountain. Jesus, help me, Lord. Overflowing fountain, living water flow. I'm done. I have nothing else to say. I have nothing else to say. It may hit me tomorrow and I may come back with a verse or something, but ciao. I have no words. Jesus was at the well.
to officially say welcome to Vlogtober. It's not that anything is super different with the vlog.
Y'all, I literally have not picked up my camera in like 4 days. But that don't even matter right now, okay? Because today is an exciting day. I got my little twisties marinating. So when I take them out later, they're gonna be right. So don't judge me right now. But I have been helping my best friend's boyfriend plan their proposal over the past couple of months, maybe like 2 months or a month and a half. And today is the day. And she has no freaking idea. And I'm so excited because, look, sis a little nosy. Morgan the type, she wanna know everything. Sis wanna know everything about everything. And when I tell you, the testimony behind this is like crazy. It's crazy. Like, I literally prayed that God would make this day perfect, like down to the weather, down to us getting her to the venue, like just everything. So the plan is, she thinks the plans are we're having a girls' day. And so one of our friends has a vineyard in their backyard. And so we're gonna use the vineyard as the spot to do the proposal. But this is like the backstory. So I mentioned, I think in another vlog, that we were having a girls' day. So 2 weeks ago, actually, we went to Raleigh and had a girls' day, got our nails done, went to look at some houses, all of those things. But that weekend, there was a storm nearby, so it rained all weekend. So we didn't get a chance to get cute. We were like, the plan was we were gonna get cute, do our makeup, do all this stuff, like go out to dinner and blah, blah, blah. But that didn't happen. Like, it literally rained all day, nonstop. Like, and not drizzling, but pouring down. So it really kind of like dampened the mood just a little bit. Like, we still went and got our nails done, but literally everywhere we went, we had to run into because it was raining and the wind was blowing that bad. So the plan was, let's give it a few weeks, let our busy schedules kind of wind down, and let's redo a girls' day. Which happened to work out because our friend that owns the vineyard, she had already been talking to Morgan about doing a girls' day where we get like really dressed up anyway. And so it was a good cover up. And I'm just thinking about how even intentional God was in that, to let it rain so bad that weekend where we couldn't get dressed up, because then we wouldn't really have an excuse to get dressed up this time. And we could have, like, she could have easily been like, well, we got dressed up last time, so let's just chill for this. And so she actually texted me, Morgan texted me, I think it was Tuesday or Wednesday of this past week, and she was like, girl, I know we got our girls day coming up Saturday, but I think I'm just wear like a chill outfit and just chill out, because, you know, whatever. And I was like, no ma'am. Remember last weekend or weekend before last, we were supposed to get dressed up and we couldn't? Mm-mm. We said we was getting dressed up and that's what we doing. And she was like, fine, I guess so. So that worked out perfectly. I helped her pick out her outfit. She has seen mine. But little does she know that she is picking her outfit out for her own proposal. So me and her boyfriend been talking back and forth, and I'm just excited. Like, all of my friends, we've been talking this morning and we're just like, bro, what the heck? Like, the day is finally here. So she's gonna ride with me, and we're first gonna go to Winston to get some dinner, and then from Winston we're gonna drive to our friend's house where the vineyard is. And inside we're gonna do like an exercise where all of us will be blindfolded, and basically we're gonna do an exercise of like talking about how it feels to have faith in God. And so, you know, sometimes realistically when we're on this journey with God, we can't see him, and so we still have to walk this journey out and trust that he's leading and guiding us wherever we go. And so the exercise is kind of going to be like that. Like, we're going to be blindfolded and our friend is going to lead us all out to the vineyard, and while we're walking, I guess we're going to be talking about, like, you know, how it feels to really do this in real time with God, and just talking about, you know, having faith when we can't see, blase, blase. Little does she know, when her blindfold comes off, all of her family and her friends will be there. and her man gonna be at the end of the Jesus at the end of the vineyard under an archway proposing to my sis. Y'all, I'm so excited. I don't know what to do. I don't have no words. So I got some studying to get done before we head to the restaurant. It's like 9:06. So I'm gonna head to the computer lab, get some work done. I told her that I would come by early so we could kind of get dressed together, do our makeup and blase blase. And so I'm gonna try to get all of that and vlog it without making it too obvious. But she knows I vlog, so hopefully she won't think anything of it. So I'm excited. It's giving. I look like a little biscuit right now, but it's all right. This ain't about me. God is really like faithful. Like the sun is out, the weather's gonna be nice today. The vineyard, her boyfriend and a couple of his friends went out to the vineyard yesterday to kind of get some things together. And everything is just coming together nicely. His mom is decorating, her mom's coming, her brother's coming. Like, I have no words. Like, if y'all knew the testimony, okay? That's all I'm gonna say. But yeah, I'm gonna try to get this on camera and I'm gonna take y'all along with me. Y'all, it is the morning after the proposal, and when I tell you God did his thing, he did his thing. Like, everything that I prayed for my friends for this weekend, he did it. And I really have no words. I'm encouraged that honestly, when my time comes, the Lord will do the same for me. and that he knows what I need. And it was perfect. We kind of had like a little dilemma before getting there. The way that our friend's house was set up, if we pulled up in the driveway a certain way where they had the food set up, she was going to be able to see it. So we had to end up being blindfolded before we got to the house. So our friend made up like an explanation of like, you know, tonight when our women's night starts, we're gonna do an exercise, but I want to try it on you guys first, and I want to blindfold you in the car. We're gonna drive somewhere, drop your cars off, and y'all are gonna get in the car with me, and I'm gonna need y'all to trust me to take you to like a beautiful place. And as we were driving to this place, which was really her house, you know, she was kind of talking to us about like trusting God, and you know, this is how it feels when you trust God. Like, you're literally in a car, you're on a journey, and God is driving, you know, your life, and you're sitting in the passenger seat blindfolded, and you're having to hear his voice, trust his guidance and his leadership and all of the things. And little did Morgan know that she was being driven to her proposal. So once we got there, it was a wrap. It was a wrap. And I just thank God that everything came together. I feel like she's gonna wake up this morning. I don't know if y'all have seen that Gabrielle Union's daughter meme or gif where she's like sitting on the side of the bed or something, and she's just kind of looking like, what the heck? I told Morgan, I said, that's gonna be her this morning when she wakes up and she sees her hand and like all the memories and all the testimonies of what God has done over the last couple of years, like starts to come back to her memory. So it came together so nice, so beautiful. After it was over, me and Anthony kind of gave each other high five, like, yes, we did it, we thank God, it's over. The pressure is done. The burden has been lifted. Okay. Amen. So, it's Sunday morning. I'm going to the 9 o'clock service because I have to get some work done today. I took off work tomorrow cause we're on fall break. And so I at least wanted a day to kind of get my life together. So this week is going to be a busy, busy week. So I may end the vlog before this week starts. Next Sunday, I'm helping to lead worship again. So this week I have to learn the songs before rehearsal on Thursday. I also have a project due on Sunday, the same Sunday that I'm leading worship, and where I have to teach a lesson plan that I created. And low key, I'm trying not to be anxious about it because I submitted the lesson plan week before last to my professor, but he never graded the lesson plan to tell me if it was right. Like, I've never done a lesson plan before. So I was kind of like, sis, like, you gonna tell us, you know, if it's right? But she never graded it because, which I understand, like, her ex-husband passed, and so she was kind of helping her daughters get some things together. So I'm trying not to be anxious about that, but the Lord is going to help me. So I think I have to record myself teaching a lesson plan to a student and submit it for a grade. So yeah, I probably will just email her to just get some clarification on some things and honestly pray about it and move forward. Cause yeah, but I'm headed to Duncan. I'm not wearing this to church, by the way, but I wanted to get just out of the house and on the move to kind of get myself up and moving before church starts. So yeah, I'm heading to Duncan to get my chai latte. And then I'm going to head back home, get dressed for church, and honestly probably study and do homework for the rest of the day. So, let's go. I'm sitting here at the computer lab. Well, not the computer lab, but at my apartment's leasing office. And I'm getting ready to close out this vlog because I really need to spend some time with God and kind of recenter my mind, especially after today's service, which was bomb. She talked about being rooted, and it was really, really good. I actually ended up staying for the 9 o'clock and the 11 o'clock service, but I'm looking at all of the assignments that I have to do this week on top of prepare to lead worship next Sunday. So I took tomorrow off work because we're on fall break to kind of recenter, and I kind of need to get some things together, and I want to get this vlog edited and up hopefully by the end of this week. So I got a lot to do this week, but I'm really gonna have to lean on God and not my own strength. So that's easier said than done, but prayerfully, not even prayerfully, I'm going to trust him and do what he has called me to do. So yeah, thank you for watching this vlog, and I will see y'all in the next one.